week for the show. And what a show it's gonna be, Dave!
Oh man, Sara, I am excited to be here. It's like Christmas and Hanukkah all rolled into one. It's gonna be a great, great time. I'm always happy to be a part of Explore Killington.
It really is, and we are rolling into over day 50 here in Killington.
Amazing.
I'm not sure what day exactly it is. With that being said, we're gonna check out the 100 day clubbers reaching for their goal this year. And if they can't get it, I don't know what's wrong with them, because the terrain up here is just amazing.
It is.
More trails opening every day, which has just been super cool. Speaking of one of the trails we're gonna take a look at, the Mouse Run Terrain Park. Killington produced an amazing piece with some local riders. We're gonna check that out. We also have a lot of other cool stuff coming up as well, huh, Dave?
We do. I'm gonna catch up with Killington events guru, Jeff Alexander. Jeff's gonna tell us about all the great events Killington has coming up in January. And also, snow scientist Tiffany is back, and she's gonna tell us about the science of snowmaking. And as a special bonus, if you haven't had enough holiday cheer yet, I know I haven't, we have a special segment from our vault, a holiday shred session.
Holiday shred session, say that three times fast. That sounds fun. Well, before we check those ones out, we are gonna also look into Pasta Pete and what's his story here in Killington. He's got some pretty funny ones for us.
I imagine her story is amazing.
I know. But first, let's take a look at the Killington produced piece from the Mouse Run Terrain Park. We've got Dave Parnell, Jamie Trayers, and Bobby Van Houten ripping it up. So let's check it out while we go take a run.
Yeah, let's do that.
Next,
we got another Killington produced segment. It's the 100 Day Club. It features Garlic's Dave Dixon and Rutland's own Jesse Gomez.
Hi, I'm Jesse Gomez. I'm 22 years old and I ride at Killington Resort.
My name is Dave Dixon and I've been skiing Killington for 23 years. This season, I'm feeling really good as far as getting back into skiing shape.
I skateboard all summer, so strap in, I take one run, and I'm back on my feet, I feel like.
I am very, very fortunate. I bartend at a fantastic restaurant down the road, The Garlic.
I work at Darkside Snowboards. I wake up, get in the car, drive up to Killington. I either have to go to work in the morning or I go ride. And then I either go ride or go to work.
It's just been a great lifestyle. I'm fortunate enough to have my home 5 minutes away from the resort. So even if I've had other things going on in life, still going to run up and do an hour and a half, 2 hours, and get some runs in, get some fun in. The biggest thing is getting out and getting some fresh air every day, realizing that this is why you live here. This is what it's all about, is getting out and just making some turns and seeing some people, and that's it. It's a great lifestyle.
It's not a challenge to get 100 days. Just go out there and enjoy your day every day on the mountain. 100 days is just another number.
That was two of Killington's own 100 Day Clubbers. Wow. Dave, have you ever gotten 100 days?
I've never made it to 100 days. I usually get about 60, 75. 1 year I was so close to making it, but I fell just a little bit short of getting that hat. But it's a great club to be in. I know we have so many friends that are in that club. It takes a lot of dedication to get out there 100 plus days like these guys do. It's amazing.
Absolutely, it takes a ton of dedication and motivation too. My boyfriend is going for it this year, and I see him every day get out of work, rush up to the mountain so that he can get a couple runs in and feel good about the day. I give him so much credit for it because I'm not sure I can do it. I get out here a lot too, but sometimes it's tough to get up here every day, so good on you guys for that. And I mean, we've got so much in store coming up on the show. We're gonna do mini shred madness. We've got Tiffany Saltis, our snow scientist, right, gonna talk about snow making. And we're also gonna check in with events guru, Jeff Alexander. So stay tuned for more Explore Killington after this.
The first trip was, I was working in the Statley Hilton, 33rd Street and 7th Avenue in New York City, and the head waiter, can't remember his name offhand, but it'll come to me, got to talking about skiing, how he loved to ski, and I told him I loved to ski, that I skied New York quite a bit, Phoenicia, Bel Air, Hunter. I've never been to Killington. He said, oh my God, he says, you have to come up and ski with Killington with me. And I said, I'd love to. And anyway, he belonged to a club down in Chittenden called High Life Ski Club. And we came up, we stayed there overnight. The next day was my birthday, and that's pretty much when first day I skied Killington. And it was awesome. Had a great day, bluebird day, lots of snow. Super, super day. I'll never forget that day as long as I live.
This is the best farmers market in Vermont and possibly in New England. And you can find just about any food you're looking to eat here. Rutland is privileged to have one of the few 52-week-a-year markets. And it feeds an economy, not just the people.
The farmers market here is open every Saturday and every Wednesday. Wednesdays from 3 o'clock to 6 o'clock, and Saturdays from 9 o'clock to 2 o'clock. And we'd really welcome everybody to come visit us.
Hi, I'm here to talk to you about the most important thing in an Italian restaurant.
And it's not the wine, it's meatballs.
And we're going to make some right now, right here at the pasta pot.
And here's the beef. Then we're going to add the egg, the onion, the parsley, salt, pepper, garlic, the breadcrumbs. And now we're cooking.
I love TV.
Would you guys like a meatball?
Pasta's meatballs smell so good. And they're tasty, too.
And remember that the Pasta Pod is the only fork spoon restaurant in the state of Vermont.
So you ready to join the ranks of the fastest growing segment of skiing today? Backcountry and Tumwark. For over 25 years, Base Camp Outfitters has been specializing in freehill skiing, uphill and downhill. That's why our pro staff can direct you through the maze of what works and what doesn't. And that means clothing too. We take warmth and comfort seriously, and that is why we offer the best brands of clothing available today. So come and visit Base Camp Outfitters right here in Killington. Be safe.
Hi, I'm Christine. Welcome to Basin Sports. We are a favorite year-round shopping destination for all things Killington, a full-service bike shop, and everything for every type of skiing and snowboarding. We demo everything we sell so you can try it before you buy it, and we've got the best performance rental fleet available in the industry. The Basin is open till midnight on Fridays, starting in December, so you can start to play early Saturday morning. We love to ski and ride, and it shows. That's why we've been here for almost 60 years. Being the oldest doesn't make you the best. Being the best makes you the oldest. Skiers serving skiers since 1958.
Sal here from Mogul's Sports Pub. You know, the only sports pub in Killington. Mogul's offers free mini golf, air conditioning, two pool tables, dart boards, and TVs everywhere. Plus the best game room around. And if you're hungry, we offer wood-fired burgers, steaks, gyros, barbecue ribs, and of course, the best lobster deal in town. So just pop in at Mogul's and say, Sal sent me. See you there.
Hey everybody, welcome back to Explore Killington. We are hanging out right outside the K1 Base Lodge. People are pumped, the skiing is fantastic, and riding, of course. I was out there yesterday, awesome conditions out here. We got more snow in the forecast, and usually with all this great snow, it means great events. I've caught up with my buddy Jeff Alexander, and Jeff, tell us about some of the great stuff we got upcoming here in Killington.
Yeah, you know, conditions are great, and we've got a jam-packed January. You know, this weekend on Saturday is the Tell a Friend Tour. We've got 8 to 9 pros, skier pros in-house. We'll be lapping the parks all day long, so keep your eyes out for those guys.
Awesome.
And then on Sunday, we have the New Schoolers Hostile Takeover competition in the Malice Run Park. It's going to be an outstanding event. Registration's up in the K1 Base Lodge.
Okay.
You know, next weekend, we continue our park theme here with the Mini Shred Madness.
You know, I'm looking forward to that.
Oh, it's awesome. DJ Dave's going to be there DJing the entire event. 13 and under, it's a great introduction to a park event. It's over at Ram's Head in the Easy Street Terrain Park.
I've heard that's great. You get the little kids out there really like showing all their hot moves and stuff. That's gonna be awesome.
Oh, it's awesome. It's great. It's that next generation, you know.
Yep.
And then, you know, the following weekend, we have a pretty big weekend. We have DeZecchi's in-house doing promotions all week long, giving away passes to get first tracks on Saturday the 21st,
which heard.
Is going to be awesome. And then we're also launching Uber as well in Killington, you know.
Wow.
So, you know, drink responsibly. So DeZecchi's is pairing up with Uber for a couple promos throughout the access road. And, you know, so the following weekend, you know, we're still rocking in January at that point. We've got the BMW event. It's a test drive event. We've got a huge amount of snow we're making back here. You'll be able to drive a BMW up and over the snow.
Oh, wow, that's going to be awesome.
15 BMWs they're bringing in. You can take them, rip them around Killington, bring them back. And that's the last weekend in January and the first weekend in February. It's going to be an awesome event.
That's going to be really cool, man. We have so many great events coming up here. You know, besides great events, I'm going to comment on this great new lid you got rocking there. What's all that all
oh,
about?
Oh, man, we're stoked. You know, Coca-Cola is a major resort partner. And what we're doing is we have the Killington Coca-Cola Prize Patrol, okay? So if you caught red-handed with a Coca-Cola cup in your hand, you could win one of these hats. It's going to happen
that's
all
awesome.
Winter long. And that crew's going to be out this weekend, so keep an eye out for them.
That's going to be great. Well, listen, everybody, that's Jeff Alexander and all the great events we got coming up here at Killington. And now check out this piece we got from Mini Shred Madness.
So there is one major rule, and the major rule is you must have fun. So let's hear some noise one more time.
I hope you guys enjoyed that piece on Mini Shred Madness. We got a great event coming up. It's January 14th over at Ram's Head in the Mini Train Park. It's kids 13 and under, and they're gonna do all kinds of like shredding and tricks and rails and all that good stuff. It's gonna be a great time. You can register on Killington.com. Once again, it's coming up next Saturday, January 14th. So it's gonna be a good time.
That does sound like a great time. Those kids are pretty amazing as well. And DJ, fun fact about Killington. Did you know that it is the number one snowmaking mountain in the eastern United States?
I did not
States?
Know that.
It is. And behind us, we've got snowmaking going on right now. They just drive the mountain with it. And we thank all our hardworking snowmakers for that. And we're going to check in with Tiffany Saltis. She's going to tell us all about the science of snowmaking.
Without snow, our winters would be a lot less this and this. Without snowmaking, there would be a lot less this and this. Snowmaking can give us a surprise powder day, as well as extend a season by months. For Killington, the math is simple. The most extensive snowmaking system on the planet has given us the longest season in the East. While the math may be simple, the science is not. The Cliff Note version goes something like this. Pressurized water particles are sprayed into the air. The colder and drier the better, and the skiing and riding awesomeness ensues. But as always, there's a little bit more to it than that, especially here at Killington. The story of these snowflakes starts long before winter. All summer long, rainfall and spring water is collected in various ponds and reservoirs in the surrounding areas. This water is then pumped through an 88-mile network of pipes by a series of pump houses, essential for providing peak-to-base snowmaking and top-to-bottom skiing and riding. So we don't need Mother Nature at all, right? Wrong. While Mother Nature can be stingy with snow, she's a bit more magnanimous with that crisp, cold, dry air of winter. Both the right temperature and humidity, that's wet bulbs to you and me, are needed to make snow. The colder and drier the air, the colder and drier the snow. At 30 degrees, humidity needs to be relatively low to make snow. At 20 degrees, humidity doesn't even matter anymore. Temperatures in the teens are perfect. The last ingredient needed to turn water into snow is compressed air, which is generated by electric and diesel compressors, powered in part by solar energy. In fact, Killington is using up to 85% less energy per gun, thanks to a variety of environmental initiatives that range from renewables like solar and cow power, and their use of low-energy snow guns. So that's it. You don't need to be a rocket scientist to understand it, but it doesn't hurt. Now it's time for me to leave the lab and engage in a little field research. Thanks for joining me. I'll see you out there.
Thank you, snow scientist Tiffany, on that awesome breakdown of snowmaking here in Killington. And I mentioned it before, Killington is the number one snowmaking resort in the East, and when I say it, I mean it. They are just hammering the mountain right now with snowmaking. We've got it over here on Highline, above us on Ovation, behind us on the World Cup Trail Superstar. Been hammering that all season long. And our snowmakers have just been going off the hook and working so hard for us. We want to give them a big thanks.
Absolutely. We have the number one snowmaking in the world. And we have a lot more coming up on this show. We have a special bonus from the vault. It's our holiday shred session. And then we caught up with Pasta Pete, and he's going to tell us his amazing Killington story. So stay tuned. There's more from Explore Killington after this.
Experience the spa at the Woods, nestled in the hills of Killington. Rejuvenate with a full spectrum of luxurious European body treatments. Indulge in the wellness of our diverse spa amenities. Let your family play in the spacious splendor of our indoor pool. Come, relax, let go. Spa at the Woods, 53 Woods Lane off the Killington Access Road. Call 422-3139 for appointments or more information.
At Northern Ski Works, we want you to have tons of fun on the snow. We'll get you on the right ski. We'll put you in the right boot. We'll get you outfitted in comfort and style. We'll get you adjusted and balanced. We'll get you finely tuned. We'll get you accessorized, and we'll outfit the kids. We'll keep you informed at northernski.com. We've got all the gear in here, so you'll have fun out there on the slopes. Northern Ski Works, conveniently located in Killington, Vermont.
Man, where's Mario?
When in Killington, Vermont, and you want some truly great pizza, Dominic's is where you want to be. We make our dough here in the restaurant every day. Every pizza is hand-tossed to order and topped with the freshest ingredients. You can taste the freshness.
Don't worry about it, guys. I got this one.
Espresso bar, specialty cocktails, art gallery, and restaurant. Liquid Art is the place in Killington to get ready for your day and unwind when it's over. We invite you to enjoy work by local artists while dining on healthy fare, signature drinks, and specialty coffee in an atmosphere that is relaxed, cozy, and unlike anything else on the mountain. Stop in for open mic night, art jam, Sunday night supper, or try one of our raved about monthly wine dinners. Killington's Coffee House, where everything is a work of art. Liquid Art, the bright blue building 2 miles up the Killington Road.
Welcome now back.
Want to tell us a little bit about that?
Oh, Sarah, do we ever. We caught up with Pasta Pete. Pasta Pete from the Pasta Pot has been in business for 43 years. The restaurant is right down there on Route 4. And Pete is just an amazing character just from the get-go. You walk in there on any day to have a meal, and he will tell you some great stories. For us, he told us so many great stories, including he met Mick Jagger.
That is really cool.
Mick Jagger came into his restaurant, and they hung out and had some really good times together. You'll have to watch the segment to see how good those times really were.
Talk about having a surprise happen to you, especially in the restaurant business. God knows who's coming through that door. One night I'm in the kitchen, quiet night, and who comes through the door but Mick Jagger and Bianca, his wife. And they sit into the dining room, and a little waitress that I had at the time, Carol Cook, said to me, she said, "Do you know who's in the dining room?" I said, I have no idea. She says, "Mick Jagger's in there." I said, "All right." I said, "Let the man eat, okay? Let him be comfortable. He's relaxing, he's not working." Well, she couldn't let that happen. She got on the phone and she called one of her friends, who called another friend, who called another friend. And by, 20 minutes later, I had 20 screaming ladies coming through the door trying to get Mick Jagger's autograph and to talk to him. Anyway, they frightened the hell out of the poor guy. He got up and he left in a hurry. I mean, he just ran out the door with his wife. And I was like so pissed off. They turn around and I'm looking and I see on the seat, he left his bag. I guess they had man bags back then. So he left his bag and I grabbed it quick because the girls were headed for it. And I said, "No," I said, "you can't have that. It's not yours. This is his. Leave this alone." Anyway, I ended up locking it in the walk-in with a lock on the door. So he called next day, his manager called, Brian something or other, and said that he'd like to come back and pick up the bag if it was all right. And I said, fine. So anyway, next day, who shows up again but Mick by himself, comes in, sits down with the girls, calls the other girls in. They all get in there. They're in the back room smoking a big doobie all together. They had a great time with him. He stayed for a couple of hours and he enjoyed himself immensely. Thanked me and out the door he went. And that's the Mick Jagger story.
Was that not an amazing story from Pasta Pete? Oh my God, you guys definitely should go down to the Pasta Pot on Route 4, ask Pete about his story. We'll have some more of his story coming up in future episodes, but please head down and ask Pete about Mick Jagger.
I know, you never know who you're gonna run into in Killington. It's such a small town, such a big place still. And we have an awesome segment coming up for you from the vault. It actually has the old Killington gondola from 1993. It's our holiday shred session with Santa Claus. Let's check it out.
It's the most wonderful time of the year. With the kids jingle belling and everyone telling you be of good cheer. It's the most wonderful time of the year. It's the happiest season of all. With those holiday greetings and gay happy meetings when friends come to call. It's the happiest season of all.
Killington Midweek is always hopping, from Bear Mountain bumpers to Bunny Busters. More people are taking the jump to Midweek Skiing. And for only $29.95 per person per night, you can land at Killington Village. In the morning, you couldn't be closer to the slopes, where you can explore 100 trails over 6 mountains. Now isn't it time you kicked up a little excitement? Take the jump to Killington, America's 6-mountain ski resort.
Shred session from the vault. Really cool with the old Killington gondola and Santa Claus there. So much history in Killington. And if you've missed any of our show today, because sadly we are coming to an end, you can check us out at KillingtonTV.com, Facebook, YouTube, Instagram, and Twitter. We also have an awesome Today Show.
We do. You can wake up with Bettina every day at 7:30 in the morning, and you can wake up with her live on the weekends.
Live on the weekends?
Yeah.
That is amazing, with our own Corey Potter as well. He's here live at the mountain.
That's awesome.
So DJ, thank you so much.
It has been so much fun
having you here. We've had a great time, and we look forward to seeing you next time. Stay classy, Killington.